It's time for a unique winter forecast that stands out from the rest, and you're going to find it right here on ONW with past El Nino breakdowns, as we're going to look at climate.gov to give you a look at some information that could impact your temp, precip, snowfall, severe forecast, and more. Let's get into it right here.
One Nation Weather.
All right, this is your official drought monitor and the forecast for how this is going to change as we go into the winter. And I really want to start with this just to kind of lead us into our precipitation talks. You can skip ahead towards the end of the video if you want to go ahead and get a look at my official outlooks for us here. But in terms of our precipitation, overall, this drought that's especially prominent there in portions of Louisiana and Mississippi is expected to wane, as well as over most of the southern corridor, as above average precipitation is typical with an El Nino event. And then in terms of these areas over the north central, as well as in the Pacific Northwest, that's where you would expect some of the drought to persist, as some high pressure ridging would overall make it warmer and drier in that region. So again, this is the El Nino pattern. Low pressures ride along the southern jet stream, so we don't really see the polar jet stream in action with El Nino. That means things are a little bit drier over the northern tier and especially warmer in that area. As you can see, the Climate Prediction Center's seasonal outlook shows below average precipitation over the north central, but an especially prominent above average precipitation area there into Florida. So let's break down the past El Ninos. There have been six strong events, and these are going to be the ones that we've really focused on since 1950, because again, these are the ones that are like this winter. So in terms of checking them off for seeing if storms have been riding up the East Coast, we saw that in the 2015-16, which is basically the strongest one. And then we've also seen that in about, say, five out of the six of these other events. We're going to give it to 1957-58, as well as 1972-73. Overall, 1991-92, we're going to have to go off on that. So around 4-5, maybe out of 6 for us here. But overall, pretty decent consensus that we get storms to especially right up the East Coast, and definitely in the Southeast see some of that precipitation. But again, this is just to show you that it's not a 100% guarantee, even with a pattern as strong as El Nino, to get this. Now, in terms of your Ohio Valley, where it's supposed to be drier than average with an El Nino event, overall, you notice that it's not really showing up there in the 2015-16, but overall, you're seeing at least traces of it here in these other years. So this is going to be the one that we're actually going to definitively give a 5 out of 6. Overall, slightly below average precipitation showing up in these zones in past years. And again, that's why I'm showing you this, because this is something that's likely to play out once again this year if you want to go with the El Nino trends, which is obviously the biggest pattern playing a role in this winter's forecast. Let's talk about the Arklatex region here, where we've got some big drought going on right now. Overall, the pattern is drier than average from in 2015 through 16, but many years for us here from 1982 to 1983, 1997 to 98, 1957 to 58, we've been wetter than average, or at least half and half across those areas. But overall, the trend is that wetter than average conditions dominate over the southern and eastern corridor of the U.S., so that's something to watch for you there in Texas. And then a unique area that I really want to talk about here is going to be this area over the plains and into the Midwest. This is an area that's not really necessarily talked about as much with El Nino. It's kind of wedged in between the warmer and the wetter areas. But overall, if you look at these strongest years, you don't really see many traces of drier than average conditions, but what you do see is wetter than average conditions. So all of these check marks are where we've got some sort of greens overall dominating in that area, whether it's just a little bit of, above average in the precipitation department or even moderately above average. This is something that's a little bit of a wow factor that we need to watch for this winter, and something that I would be interested in for the potential of a few troublemaking storms over that region. And then, of course, along the West Coast, can't leave you out there. We've got these areas here in the Pacific Northwest in some of these recent strong El Ninos that have definitely, come out of some sort of atmospheric river event. This is to prove to you here that even along the northwestern coastline where ridging can develop, we can still get these systems to hit the West Coast, and that's about in 4 of 6 of those. So again, about a 2 out of 3 chance that you're wetter than average if you follow the guidance there. So here's my official winter precipitation forecast. This is number 2. I'll have a final one at the end of November, but you can see overall a little bit below average in the precipitation department, especially on up into the northern Ohio Valley, there around Lake Erie. Of course, all the Great Lakes a little bit below average in that department, as well as over the north central. The West Coast a bit above average in the precipitation department. Notice how I also have that zone moving into the Midwest, but it's right there in the southeast where I'm expecting the most storms, and of course, that's something that's been unwavering really through most El Nino years. Your temperature outlook from the Climate Prediction Center shows above average over pretty much the entire northern half of the country, with pretty high certainty in near normal temperatures there in the south central. Let's break down past El Ninos in the temperature department. Again, let's talk about the north central, since that's normally the most prominent area for warmer than average conditions. You see it there in 2015 through 16, which had a record-breaking warmth in that department in December. Pretty much this entire area checking off in all of these except for the 1972 to 73 graphic. So point being here, in fact, it was very strong heat in comparison to average in all of these. So pretty much really checking off there, and that's really one of the most prominent things that I've seen so far in any of these graphics. You can notice overall a cooler than average just El Nino year overall in 1972 to 73, but the 57 to 58 event was one that was a little bit cooler than average over the southeast, which doesn't really reflect anything since it's not shown in any others. So really the only prominent temperature pattern that you see with El Nino, other than some maybe cooler than average conditions there in Texas, is going to be over the north central, and maybe if you even focus in on specific details there, into the Four Corners region, you can see overall some blues. So something interesting there in the, you know, the below average temperature department for us there. So that's going to be what we're going to talk about with that. And then elsewhere across the country, nothing big in the trends. Again, just circling these areas over the north central again, because they're really the prominent areas that are need to be focused on for warmer than average conditions. So yeah, you pretty much get the drill. And then one last thing, in Maine, we've seen some warm years as well as some cooler years, so that kind of evens out. The northeast, though, overall trends warmer than average during El Nino, which is why with your temperature forecast for us, you can see we've got the warmer than average conditions especially prominent there into the Dakotas, Minnesota, as well as the Upper Peninsula of Michigan in northern Wisconsin. These areas on my level 3 out of 4 certainty for us for above average winter conditions, so that's definitely pretty major there. Elsewhere across the northern part of the country, pretty much the northern half, at least somewhere above average. I've got a small below average zone from portions of southern Arizona and southern New Mexico on over into Texas. But overall, that's not going to be necessarily a temperature anomaly that wins out. Now, when you combine temperatures and precipitation, you kind of get into the severe weather and snowfall possibility. So let's talk about severe weather. Overall, maybe some severe weather there along the southern California and southern Arizona zones. But it's really going to be here into the mid-south where we have at least the possibility of some severe weather. But really moving on over from southeastern Texas, right along that Gulf Coast, and over to the Atlantic coast there in the southeast, where we're going to have the best possibility of severe weather, especially there into central Florida from place for your favorite theme parks there, as well as towards Tampa Bay. Now, this is my ONW winter snowfall versus average map. Overall, from the mountains here, say the Sierra Nevada range there in California, especially into the Four Corners, and then on over right up to the Appalachian chain there on the East Coast, I'm expecting above average precipitation by at least a little bit, but especially there in the Four Corners, and a good bit below average in the snowfall department there. If you live over the north central, which of course correlates with that well below average or well above average temperatures and the slightly below average precipitation. So here's what this comes out to: stormy along the west coast with an atmospheric river event possibly setting up, and it's something that we've seen with El Nino events in the past. Milder than normal with a bit less snow there into the mountain west. Much snowier than you should be there in the Four Corners. Potential trouble there into portions of the mid-south and the midwest. I would be watching for maybe a couple unexpected severe weather events, but nothing too crazy this winter, maybe a little wetter than average. Wet with some more snow than you might expect there in the southeast, with our best severe zone, of course, going to be there into portions of Florida. Much warmer and drier there over the northern tier, especially there into the northern Great Lakes as well as the northern plains. Dry in the Ohio Valley and warm, but big snows possible as some of those systems right up the East Coast. Something still with a question mark there in the Northeast. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, go ahead and like, subscribe, and I do forecast for the entire lower 48 and the tropics, so you have that coming as well. So don't just think that I'm a winter forecast channel. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.